Hey everybody, it's Mark of ManLookSings, and today I want to walk you through the process how we got to this 8x10 lift with the stitching on top. So let's talk about how I took my last shot on the Polaroid material, the 8x10 impossible stock actually. Was it Polaroid Originals? I think it was still an impossible that I had, and that was the last frame, and I hope PO produces some new 8x10 film, because it has been a pretty long time since I got my hand on some new films. So 8x10 films. And I can't wait to. Because that format is just amazing. I love it, and it's nothing like the 20x24, but still it's huge, it's a little easier to handle, to travel with, and you can get such amazing results that actually don't need to be enlarged or anything, because just publish them at an exhibition like they are, right? And the process of my last Polaroid of this here, like the one I shot now, was actually pretty interesting. I had Sophie over, she's the model actually, and the one who helped me with the stitching here. And she did a pretty amazing job. What we did is we made a lift. And the lift, some of you have seen the video I did already. If you haven't, it should be linked somewhere up there where I show the whole process for black and white. For color it's a little different, it's just the material is a little bit hard to get off at the moment. I should actually do a new video for the color film at the moment. But yeah, but in that video I showed you one 8x10 lift, and that's the one of Mirel. That's this one here. And that's actually one of my favorite lifts. And just to show you, that's actually the same film. And you see the difference, what happens over time with these films. Fresh film? Fresh film? Old film. Just the tint of the color and the aging process. I love the shot of Mirel, like all these little wrinkles here and everything. It's just a beautiful, beautiful image. And Mirel is also amazing in that image. So that was an amazing shot, and a lot of you asked actually how I did that shot. It was taken with an 8x10 format camera. So with this one here. And after that, we made a lift. So the process is, first you take your image. You need your 8x10 camera, you need your 8x10 processor, you need the film, which hopefully comes back in March, and then you need to take your image. It's a little bit complicated with these cameras, because they are so basic, it gets complicated for you to actually handle all the stuff. Like, actually 8x10 is super easy. You have the front, the back, you move them till you like it, set the focus, to be honest, and that's it. Then you take your shot, like with a regular camera. And after you took that image on your Polaroid negative, you go to your processor where you marry together your 8x10 negative and positive with the pots. The positive comes with the pots, you put that in the processor, the image runs through the processor. Once it's out of the processor, it needs to stay in the dark, like a Polaroid should, since that's old chemistry, for a few minutes, and then it's developed. So after the image is developed, we start with our lift technique. The lift technique is similar to a small Polaroid, it's just a lot more fragile. The image is a lot bigger, it's easier to get chemistry strains on the image, but since we are doing a lift, we don't care about that too much. If we would go for transparency, we really have to watch out to get the right timing and the right curvature when bending. But I always try to get a clean as possible transparency if I do a lift. That was the first part. And as you can see, the chemistry is a little bit dry, so we didn't cover the whole image. And that's something you have to watch out. If the chemistry doesn't cover the whole image, you need to cut off more of the material. So if it would cover the whole image, which could just like put it into water like that and get the emulsion off the PVC layer. But if it doesn't cover the whole image, you need to cut off these little like bubbles. And that's a really important part, because like drops actually. Because at these drops I found that the emulsion sticks really well to the material and tends to rip there, and then you have a little like tension point, and then the whole Polaroid takes apart. So for example, on this here, you can see it ripped off here at the pieces. I still managed to put it back, and it also works with color film. That's actually Nathan Gray from Boys It's Fire. Lovely portrait of him. I like that. And yeah, then we have Reverend Beatman here. Red pigment looks also good, like, you know what you can do with these wrinkles, that looks, gives that really nice touch. We go to the lift. We have our transparency, and now we just need our big water pan. Like, since 8x10 is pretty big, we need a big water tank where we can put it into the water. It should be a little bit warm, like hand warm, and then it slowly starts coming off the PVC layer. You will need some like brushing or with your fingertips to move it off the PVC, and then you take your big paper, as with the small ones. For the small ones, I actually just cut these big sheets into smaller pieces and use them. So for the big one, I just use the whole sheet and put the Polaroid on it. And then it gets a little bit tricky, because the material is really flimsy at that point and it's easy to tear apart. So really need to take your time and lift it slowly out of the water to get your lift. After we took our lift, we took some time. So a few days later, Sophie came over when the lift was dry and the paper had time to actually flatten a little bit. What I do, like when the lift is out, these big papers, they start to curl, as you can see, like this. So what I do is I put them between wooden plates with some silk paper and pressure them together so they flatten out. As you can see, the one of Mireille is pretty flat already again. So that's the technique I use for flattening it. So afterwards, Sophie came over and we had the idea to actually make something special since she's into stitching a lot, as you can as you have seen in the video of stitching, which will also be linked right now. And she stitched a little quote on it. We weren't sure what to do because the picture is already like really settled and we didn't want to overwhelm us with the stitching. So we just went for a little text on top. So we just went with this nice little quote, as you can see. And I think that fits the image a little bit. Like, her emotions are the loudest when she's silent. It fits really well to that like really like soft image, the shallow view of her. And what she did, she made her little transparency where she wrote the text and then she started puncturing the holes, fixed the transparency to the paper so she has the template, and then she started stitching all on the Polaroid. And that's actually the process we used for our 8x10. So that's my last sheet of 8x10. I hope I get some new one soon, really soon, because if I don't, I will start crying. It's an amazing film and it's lovely to shoot. So when I get a new pack of film, I will start the whole 8x10 process and show you the details of it. But this time I just wanted to give you a little summary of the whole process, how to combine these creative mediums. We did one where we did lift, we did one where we did stitching, and now we're combining these two. So that's actually the process. If you have any questions or ideas or ask, like, put them in the comments below. If you liked the video, thumbs up. If you didn't, thumbs down. And I hope to see you next time. Bye.